Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are going to see about a new series of playlists. We'll be integrating admin panel, how to use that and all those things. So before getting started, if you are new to this channel, do subscribe and hit on the bell icon. So whenever I upload a new video, you will be getting a notification on it. Do follow me on my Instagram page as well. Let's get started. So for admin panel, let us go search for admin dashboard template. So when we search this, we'll be getting different kind of templates from different kinds of website. So here, before choosing the template, let us go create one folder inside our XAMPP. So inside Windows C XAMPP, I have HD docs, and here inside Sneha codes, there is Sneha code. Inside Sneha codes, I'll right click and create one folder as admin panel. I've named this as admin, or else we'll rename this to admin dashboard. So rename this to admin dashboard. Now let us open this with VS Code editor. So here you go, here I've opened it. And now we can't directly view the output. So what we'll do is we'll create one index.php file. And inside this index.php, I'm going to tell in an h4 tag hello. So let us go reload this output and check localhost/snehacodes/admin-dashboard. And hit enter. So we are getting hello. Here you can add index.php. This will also give you the same output. If you are not adding anything, this will call that index. If you want, you can give, or else you can just leave that. What we are trying to do here is we are going to integrate admin dashboard. So when I typed admin dashboard template, I had different templates from different website. I prefer creative temp. Let us go to this website. I'll give you guys the link in the description. Do check it out. So here, first thing what you have to do is you have to log in. So let me log in first. I have logged into this website. So when you scroll down, you have here all templates, admin dashboard, UI kits, free templates. So click on free templates here. And when you scroll, you get the dashboard. I'll be using this thing because this is the free template with the latest Bootstrap 5. Okay, this also we can use, but this is Bootstrap 4. We'll be using Bootstrap 5, but both are of same. You can use anything. There's no problem in that. So if you want, you can live preview before integrating this. So this is how the admin dashboard is going to look. So here we have all these sidebar, navbar. Let us click on this and you will get your free download. Click on free download and download zip file. So I have downloaded here. So it will be in my downloads folder. So let's go to downloads. Let's extract this. Extract all. Extract. So this is a extracted file. So inside this extracted folder, if you want to check, you can just click on this index.html and this will give the website. So let's remove this thing. So we have got website. So now you can see all the files here, like there are different files, and we'll see how to integrate those different files in a clear format. So how to form that particular file structure as well. What we are going to do here is let us open this with VS Code. First we'll understand which file is placed where, and then we'll start working with it. You can see the index.html. This is actually the real, I mean this, everything is there in index.html. So every file is included here, every CSS, JS, all the content, all the design is included here. So this template.html is the same of that. This is used to integrate into the projects. This template is a basic sample of this index. So first what we have to do is, here we have the admin dashboard which we have created. First thing we have to do is create a folder for admin. So admin will be the separate. Admin will have all the special access, all the special permission, everything. So inside this admin, I'm going to create one index.php. Here also what I'll tell is, in an h4 tag, I'll tell hello. and let me go reload this page. So now how to access that admin dashboard? Let's keep differently. Allow admin. So now how to access that admin file which you have created? Simple, just give the admin folder there and give a slash, and here you go, you get that. So this is how you access your admin file. Here what we'll do is, we want this dashboard, right? So for that, we understood one thing, that is index file is the entire thing and the template is for us to integrate into other projects. So here we can see that we have all the links here, and this aside tag is nothing but your sidebar. So let's close this, and this is your main tag, and inside main tag you have navbar, and this will be the main content and footer. So footer is inside the main content. What we'll do is, we'll just cut this footer and paste it outside that. Here is a footer. Now this will be the main content where this should be inside every file that you create. This they have just done it in one file. So we are not going to do that inside one file. We will be creating multiple files and segregating that, which makes the code look easier and understandable for everyone. Here we have created one admin. So inside admin, I'll create one folder which is includes. Inside this includes folder, I'm going to right click and create header.php. Basically what I'm trying to do here is, I'm going to place all that header code separately, footer code separately. So I'm going to divide that code which is there in template. Here I've created one file which is header.php. Inside header.php, from this line number 15 to line 39 till the body, we'll just copy. So from here, copy and go to this header and paste. So I've pasted this inside header. Now what we should do is, so header is done. Next we have the sidebar. So let's copy this sidebar, copy and go to includes, create another folder. Tell this as sidebar.php, and inside sidebar, just paste your aside tag. So now the sidebar is also pasted. So what you do once you paste this, just format those documents so it will be aligned properly, okay? Here also let's format. So this header and sidebar is done for now. Now let's check what else we have. So we have this main. Let us copy this main. So this main is going to be inside header. So let's copy this and paste it inside header here. So if you notice properly in this template, before this main we have the sidebar, and here you can do this in two ways. Either you can include your sidebar inside index.php, or else you can include your sidebar here itself. When you include your sidebar in this header page itself, what will happen is that line of code will not be repeated. In index.php, while including, we have to include all the file which is there in includes folder. So this, what it does is, it will give two line of code extra. When you do it inside your header itself, that will not be happening, including here. So I'm gonna tell php open close php and tell include function, and inside you can see sidebar.php. Here no need to add this folder name because we are inside the include folder, so you can just add the file. Here we have copied the main. Let's copy the navbar now. Copy and go create one new file navbar.php and paste it here. Format document. So navbar is done. So navbar also is the same thing. So just like this. So what we are going to do here, so why I am pasting it after this main is, when you see this template, you can understand that navbar is after this main. So we are going to include. So copy, paste this here, and just change this to navbar. That's it. We have done till navbar. The next thing that we have to do is, this is the main content. Before main content, let's add this footer. This is actually not required. Let's close that. And from footer, open close footer to close of main. I'm just copying it and creating another file, which is footer.php, and pasting it here. So now the footer is included and we have the main here. Let us scroll down. So here you have open close. This is very important. So copy this and paste it here. So why this is important is because we have opened in header, we have to close in footer. Now this is done. We have divided all these, which is a sidebar, navbar, header, footer. We have created a separate folder and file and added, and we have included. Now let us go reload this and check what is happening. So we are not getting anything. That is because we have not included that header and footer here, right? So what we are going to do is we'll just tell PHP using include, tell includes slash header and copy paste and tell footer. We have just included header, footer. Let us go reload. This will not work. I'll tell you why. So we have got everything, but the CSS is not set. So we have to include the CSS and JS links, right? To include CSS and JS, what I am doing is, here you can see the CSS file is here. So inside assets folder, CSS, material-dashboard.css. Okay, let's go to assets folder. Inside CSS, we have material-dashboard.css. So all these files are same. So what we are going to do is, we will be copying this minified version. We'll use this minified version inside our project. So copy this minified file. And let us go to this admin, click on folder and create one folder, which is assets. Inside this assets, create another folder, which is CSS. Inside the CSS, create a file and paste. Sorry, no need to create a file. We have already copied. We just need to paste it. So inside, just paste it. So you got this here, which is material-dashboard.min.css. Everything is similar. This is just the minified version. Similar way, we have the JS also, JS file. So here, the other things are like icons, font and icons. This is all not much necessary for now. Scroll down here, you have all the JS file. So here you can see core JS. So we are going to copy this popper and bootstrap. Let's open this JS. Inside core, you can see bundle. So combination of popper and bootstrap is your bundle. So let's copy this bundle. So go copy. So I've just copied that. And here inside assets, I'm gonna create a folder, which is JS. So inside JS, I'm directly going to paste it. Let us go to header.php. Let's see the path. We are going to remove this and tell assets. Inside assets, we have CSS folder. Inside CSS folder, the name of the file is material-dashboard.min.css. Let's remove this version thing and add a min here, min.css. Now the CSS is included. Similar way, we have to do it for the JS. So here, let's go to templates, copy one of this, copy. I'm just copying one of that and pasting it here. So your script has to be here inside footer. So here also similar way, remove this. And here we don't have another folder, which is core. So let us remove that core. And instead of popper.min.js, let us right click, rename, copy this and paste it here. So this is the file name. So now we have included both the CSS and JS. Inside this also, we have just included header and footer. Okay, let's go reload our output and check. Reload. So we have got the sidebar, we have got the navbar, we have got the footer, everything is there. Let us remove this logo. Actually, this logo thing we didn't insert here, right? Which is there in image. So go to sidebar, open this, and here you have an image. Comment it for now. If you want to add an image, you can do it. And I'll change this name to admin dashboard. Okay, admin dashboard. This also we'll remove all that creative trim and all those things which is there inside footer. Here we have footer. let's have only one link, and for now it's not gonna be license. Tell this as about, and we have one thing which is this. Here you can just mention Sneha codes or done this. We will add the content, which is this. Once after adding all those things, we need to add the content. So we are just going to copy this and paste it inside our index.php here. Okay, this you can do it, but then I'm just going to copy the same thing. So yeah, here we have this container fluid and we have one row and class. Inside this we need to paste this thing, right? For that, let us go to index.php. You will have this container fluid. Copy the first row. Let us copy this and paste it inside this column MD dual. Just paste. Just format document this and go reload your page. So we have got here, what else is left? So we have to make this active, right? Let us go to HTML and see which button is active there. You can do in two ways. If you are not finding the name of that button, you can go right click, inspect and do. So I'm gonna close this row. So that is inside sidebar, right? So here we have aside. Let's open this aside. And which was it? So here you can see, is dashboard active? What you can do is, you can just go inspect this dashboard. You can do this if you are not finding inside your index.html. That class name is missing here inside index. So what you can do is, alternative way, just go right click on this. Where is it? Right click on this inspect. And you can see here the name nav link bg active bg gradient primary. Let's copy that. Simple, from here to here you copy and go to your index where you should show inside sidebar. Click on sidebar and this thing, right? Inside this nav white text, just add this class name. So this class will make this active. So this is not done dynamically, but for now we are doing it this way. In future videos we'll be doing, when we are clicking on that tab should be active. Okay, we'll do that in future videos. Now let's go reload the dashboard. So you got this active button. This pages and template is not actually required. Let's go remove that and give some other thing. Inside navbar we have this nav. Let's remove that and tell in an h4 tag welcome. Go reload. You just got welcome. So that's it in this video. In this video we have seen how to integrate an admin dashboard into your project. In upcoming videos we'll see about the CRUD, how it is performed here. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any kind of doubt or suggestion, let me know in the comment section. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next video.